Hello student, now we are going to start our new point, that is integrated rate law. Integrated rate law. In last video lecture, we studied how to calculate molecularity of chemical reaction, or what is the concept of molecularity of chemical reaction. And in our previous video lecture, we studied rate law. Okay, now we are going to start our new point, that is integrated rate law. In our syllabus there are two integrated rate law, the integrated rate law for first order reaction and integrated rate law for second order reaction. Now we are going to start, that is integrated rate law for first order reaction. Integrated rate law for first order reaction. Okay, now let us consider the equation, that is reactant A is converted into product P. Reactant A is converted into product P. There are the two ways of writing rate law. Number first, we have to calculate rate of chemical reaction, that is rate is equal to the stoichiometric coefficient of reactant is 1. So negative sign indicates these are the reactant, minus del in bracket A divided by del T. Okay, or in case of instantaneous, minus D in bracket A divided by DT. Okay, now in second form, rate is equal to how to write rate law? Rate law, it is experimentally determined quantity. Now our equation is for first order chemical reaction, so it indicates rate is equal to K in bracket A, stoichiometric coefficient is also 1, and the order of reaction, that is first order chemical reaction. Okay, these are the two ways we are studying earlier. Now we are joining these two equations, or combining these two equations, we are taking this and this. Okay, now let us joining these two equations. Okay, it gives rate, also write rate is equal to, both are the equal, this is the different forms of expressing rate of chemical reaction. Rate is equal to minus D in bracket A divided by DT is equal to K in bracket A. Okay, it is also correct to expressing rate of chemical reaction. Okay, now rearrange the equation. Suppose this in bracket A is shifting here and DT is shifting here. Okay, now rearrange the chemical equation. Rearrange the chemical equation, we get, I am directly taking, I want to shift negative sign. तुमचं मॅथ्स आहे, तुमच्या लक्षात येते, D in bracket A divided by in bracket A is equal to minus K DT. ओके, आय एम कंबाइनिंग दिस इक्वेशन. कसं आलं, हा के जो होता पॉझिटिव, हा तिकडे गेल्यावरती निगेटिव्ह. रिअरेंज दिस इक्वेशन, वी गेट इक्वेशन नंबर, लेट अस से फर्स्ट. ओके, देन इंटिग्रेशन, बाय अप्लाइंग इंटिग्रेशन टू द बोथ साइड, दिस आर द डिफरेंशिएशन. डिफरेंशिएशन कॅन्सल कोण करते, इंटिग्रेशन करते ना. These are the two equations. Now we applying integration to the both side. Let us consider reactant A is converted into product. Okay, initial concentration, that is A0. Let us say I am taking the capital letter of A0. Okay, at time is equal to zero. We studied it earlier. Then concentration of reactant is decreases. It gives AT. Concentration of reactant is decreases. It gives AT at time T. At time T. Okay. Then by applying the limit to the both sides, we regarding time 0 to time T, regarding concentration A0 to AT. Okay. Now by applying integration between two limits, that is integrating initial concentration A0, okay, then final concentration is AT. Yeah, this is D in bracket A divided by A, okay, is equal to negative sign indicates, or negative sign always placed to the left side of the integration sign. Integrating between the limit of time 0 to t is equal to k dt. K dt. Okay. These are the, by applying integration to the both side. Now rules are here. As you know, there are some rules for integration and derivation. Now first of all, we'll take here. Okay, then here. Or k is also constant, we can shift here, but it laterally. So rule indicates dx upon x, dx upon x is equal to natural log x. Dx upon x is equal to natural log x. So natural log, it is the log to the base t. Natural log means log to the base t. Okay. Now, so what is the conversion there? dA upon A, dx upon x is equal to natural log x. So dA upon A is equal to natural log A. Natural log A. Natural log A. Between limit A0 is the lower limit and AT is the upper limit. Okay. Is equal to minus, I'm k shifting here because k is a rate constant, negative sign and the constant are placed to the left side of integration sign, 0 to t dt. Okay, now I'm taking rule number 2, that is here, rule number 2, integrating dx is equal to x. Integrating dx is equal to x. Now, integrating dt is equal to t. Integrating dx is equal to x. Then integrating dt is equal to t. Okay. Now, next step of our derivation is natural log A. Lower limit, that is A0, upper limit, that is AT, is equal to minus K, remains it as it is. So integrating DT is equal to T. Between lower limit 0 and upper limit T. Okay. Now these are the conversions for integration rate law for first order reaction yet. Okay. Now let us move to the next step, that is these are the natural log A, lower limit A0, upper limit AT is equal to minus KAT0 to T. Okay, now next move to the next rule for regarding this particular equation, that is f of x, rule of f of x, the lower limit of x is a and upper limit of x is b, then it is converted into fb minus fa, fb minus fa. Okay, now let us see here, it is exactly same as like this, natural log at minus natural log a0. So it is converted into natural log at, concentration always expressed in square bracket, because at is the decreased concentration after time t, a0 is the initial concentration at time 0. Okay, now natural log at minus natural log a0, natural log at minus natural log a0 is equal to minus k t, t minus 0, integrations are rule, t minus 0 is equal to t, so I am directly writing here only t. Okay, then natural log at minus natural log a0, the rule of logarithm says if minus are there then equation must be divided with each other, then what's the next, natural log at upon, because of minus, natural log a0 is equal to minus kt, is equal to minus kt. This is a very important equation for us. This is equation number first, I can write here. Natural log at upon natural log a0 is equal to minus kt. Now, if I rearrange this, I want to cancel the negative sign for k. So, the opposite side, that is reshuffle. So it converts natural log a0 divided by natural log at is equal to kt, a0 natural log at by a0, it converted into natural log a0 upon natural log at, and minus sign is cancelled out. Okay, then I want to convert the equation for that particular way, that is I want only necessary for k. So what is the value of k? K is equal to, k is equal to, let us convert it, 1 by t. Okay, natural log, I want to common natural log for both the reactant, the concentration of reactant and concentration at time t. Okay, natural log shabda common kadla, mag kt, t jar parivar shift kela tar 1 by t honar na. Okay, tumcha lakshat aale, t parivar shift kela tar 1 by t honar hai, natural log common kadla ami, natural log a0 by at. Okay, then I want to convert natural log into simple logarithm. What is the value it comes from? The value is 2.303. So our next equation is k is equal to 2.303 to the base, divided by t log to the base 10 a0 upon at. This is the equation number 2 for integrated rate law for first order reaction. K is equal to 2.303 by t log to the base 10, because natural log converted into base 10, the value is given by 2.303, log to the base 10 is 0 by 80. Okay, then these are the two second form of integrated rate law for first order reaction. Now take a screenshot of this equation, because you have to calculate there are number of numericals for that particular type. Okay, now let us move to the third equation for integrated rate law for first order reaction. Remember, equation number first is given by natural log AT divided by A0 is equal to minus KT. The equation number first I can write here earlier. So natural log, I am common natural log of natural log AT divided by natural log A0. Okay. Then taking anti-log to the both side. Taking anti-log to the both side. Both sides. It gives, I am directly writing here, AT divided by A0 is equal to base E to the power minus KT. Base E to the power minus KT. Because natural log means log to the base E. Log to the base E. Okay, here also log to the base E. The rule says log to the base E is equal to X. So AT by A0 is equal to E to the power minus KT. Therefore, AT is equal to A0 ikkada gelo A0 E to the power minus KT. A0 into E to the power minus KT. This is the another form of integrated rate law for first order reaction. Okay. Now let us move to the another formula for first order chemical reaction. Okay, take a screenshot of this equation. Okay. Now we are going to start another form of integrated rate law for first order chemical reaction. Our main and principal formula for first order integrated rate law for first order chemical reaction is K is equal to 2.303 divided by T log to the base 10 A0 divided by AT. Let us understand this. A0 is the initial concentration and AT is the final concentration, means concentration decreases at time T. Okay, let us consider that reactant A is converted into product. As I said earlier, the initial concentration of reactant is A0 at time 0, because reaction is not starting yet. Okay, now concentration is decreases with time. So final concentration at time t is equal to t means 1 hour, 2 hour, let us say whatever you want to take any number, it inserted. A0 initial concentration, at final concentration. Okay, now what is the value of AT? Remind my second video lecture, AT it convert into A0 minus X, because suppose A0 is the initial concentration, that is 10 molar, and concentration decreases at 2 hours, that is 5 molar. A0 is 10 molar, AT is 5 molar. Okay, then alternatively I can write AT is equal to 10 minus 5. 10 minus 5, so answer is 5. Okay, 10 minus 5 means 10, which is the value of A0, minus 5 is the value of X. So AT must be 5, answer must be 5. This is the alternative way. So I am writing here A0 minus X. Okay, so I want to replace AT with A0 minus X. That is the another formula for present integrated rate law for first order chemical reaction. Okay, now this is the another formula for integrated rate law for first order reaction. K is equal to 2.303 divided by T log to the base 10. Initial concentration will not be changed. AT it is converted into A0. Okay, I am writing here capital letters. You can use small letters also. Don't worry. AT minus A0 minus X. Okay. Or you can use small letters also. A0 or A divided by A0 minus X or A minus X. Okay. Whatever may be little. I think in textbook can write K is equal to 2.303 divided by T log to the base 10. Initial concentration A0 indicated in small a in textbook. So you can use this. This is also correct. Not don't worry about that. Divided by A minus X. Okay. The symbol, only symbol is changed. Nothing will be changed. Okay. So this is the formulae, integrated rate law for first order reaction. Okay. You can use it in by solving numericals, to the solving of numericals. Then what your next point is unit of rate constant K. Unit of rate constant K. Our next point is unit. What is the unit of rate constant K? Let us say this term log to the base 10, the formula of integrated rate law, I am writing here as a real. Log to the base 10 A0 by AT means concentration expressed in molar, m divided by m. So cancel out. So log to the base 10 m divided by m. So it is unitless quantity. Unitless quantity. So only remaining K is equal to 2.303 divided by T. Means K is equal to reciprocal of time. Reciprocal of time. Reciprocal of time. So 1 by T or 2.303 by T. The unit of time is second. So second over here is second inverse. Minute asel tar minute inverse. Hour asel tar hour inverse honar. Reciprocal of time. Okay. Unit of K is equal to second inverse, minute inverse and hour inverse. Okay. Here is the unit of K. Okay. Now we are going to start our next derivation, that is half-life for first order chemical reaction. Half-life for first order chemical reaction. So you want to know what is the meaning of half-life. In 11th standard we studied half-life, the point regarding nuclear chemistry. Okay. Half-life means time required to reduce half of the initial concentration. Time required to reduce half of the initial concentration. Let us move to the detailed concept of half-life. In a reactant A is converted into product P. Initial concentration of reactant is A0 at time is equal to 0. The concentration decreases at time T. It is equal to AT. Okay. The definition of half-life is, let us say it is initial concentration or it is final concentration. Okay. So time required to reduce half of the initial concentration. Manje initial concentration cha half karaychan, time pan ardhas honar. Ardha tevda chala na. Initial concentration 10 asel 0 time la. Barabar. Tar final concentration एक असेल एक तासाला. बरोबर. तर हाफ बरोबर हाफ म्हणजे किती तर बघा टाइम रिक्वायर्ड टू रिड्यूस हाफ ऑफ द इनिशियल कॉन्सन्ट्रेशन एट टाइम टी इज इक्वल टू झिरो इनिशियल कॉन्सन्ट्रेशन एट झिरो टाइम इज इक्वल टू ए झिरो देन एट टाइम टी ए टी आय डोंट वॉन्ट टू कंप्लीट फुल रिएक्शन आय वॉन्ट टू हाफ सो एट टी वन हाफ इज इक्वल टू ए झिरो बाय टू ए झिरो बाय टू बिकॉज टाइम रिक्वायर्ड टू रिड्यूस हाफ ऑफ द इनिशियल कॉन्सन्ट्रेशन इनिशियल कॉन्सन्ट्रेशन 10 मोलर आहे बरोबर त्याचं अर्ध व्हायला 10 to 5 व्हायला टाइम पण अर्धा आपल्याला या रिएक्शनच्या मधलंच बघायचंय ना ऍट टाइम टी टी म्हणजे रिएक्शन पूर्ण झाली समजा 2 तासात पूर्ण झाली मग 2 तासात ए टी येणार मला ए टी नकोय मला ए झिरोचं अर्ध ए झिरोचं अर्ध म्हणजे ए झिरो बाय टू मग टाइम पण अर्धाच लागलं ना त्याला टाइम पूर्ण कसा लागेल टी इज इक्वल टू टी अशी रिएक्शन संपल्यावर टी वन हाफ येणार ओके द टाइम रिक्वायर्ड टू रिड्यूस हाफ ऑफ द इनिशियल कॉन्सन्ट्रेशन टाइम रिक्वायर्ड टू रिड्यूस हाफ ऑफ द इनिशियल कॉन्सन्ट्रेशन इज कॉल्ड एज हाफ लाइफ ओके नाउ लेट अस गोइंग टू द डिटेल डेरिवेशन ऑफ हाफ लाइफ ओके हाफ लाइफ ची कन्सेप्ट क्लियर केमिस्ट्री मध्ये 11th स्टँडर्ड तुम्ही शिकलेलाच आहात तरी पण थोडक्यात रिमाइंड करून दिली नाउ दिस इज द बेसिक डाटा फॉर द डेरिवेशन ऑफ इंटिग्रेटेड सॉरी हाफ लाइफ फॉर फर्स्ट ऑर्डर रिएक्शन ओके सो अवर इक्वेशन इज के इज इक्वल टू इंटिग्रेटेड रेट लॉ फॉर फर्स्ट ऑर्डर रिएक्शन इज गिवन बाय k is equal to 2.303 divided by t log to the base 10 a0 divided by at so I want to replace the value of t this is the integrated rate law for first order reaction after completion of reaction not middle or not half of the equation or reaction so t is replaced by t1 half and at is replaced by a0 by 2 so it gives next equation k is equal to 2.303 divided by t1 half log to the base 10 इनिशियल कॉन्सन्ट्रेशन ए झिरो चेंज झालेलं कॉन्सन्ट्रेशन अर्धा पाहिजे टाइम पण अर्धाच ए झिरो बाय टू टाइम रिक्वायर्ड टू रिड्यूस हाफ ऑफ द इनिशियल कॉन्सन्ट्रेशन ओके देन व्हॉट इज अवर नेक्स्ट स्टेप आय थिंक ए झिरो अँड ए झिरो आर कॅन्सल आउट सो आय थिंक हिअर आय कॅन राईट के इज इक्वल टू 2.303 डिवाइडेड बाय टी 1 half log to the base 10 I think 2 only remaining log to the base 10 2 okay this is our next step okay then the next equation or next equation number I think 1 is given by k is equal to 2.303 divided by t 1 half What is the value of log to the base 10 to I think 0.3010 okay then multiplication for this 2.303 into 0.3010 is equal to I think 0.693 because इतक्या वर्ष शिकवते त्यामुळे व्हॅल्यू पार झाली इज इक्वल डिवाइडेड बाय टी वन हाफ This is our first equation for indicating half life. Now, equation 2, t1 half. t1 half is equal to, okay, ikda yana, t1 half ikda jana na. 0.693 divided by k. This is equation number 2. Ya don formula varthi numerika, don marka che vichale jata. Okay, this is the equation for half life for first order reaction. In this lecture, we studied half-life and integrated rate law for first-order reaction. Okay, hopefully you have understood this. If any doubt or query, you can ask me personally. or in WhatsApp group or in comment section. Okay, hopefully you have understood this. Thank you.